Hi, Tony Vera in Hollywood, California, watching the Boyz II Men get their Hollywood Walk of Fame star. In this video, they talk about the late Teena Marie, and you see them with their fans. Here's the video.
From Hamburg here in Heidelberg, and we have some from Detroit. Anybody else from out of town? Australia, Aussies, all right. Philadelphia, I knew there would be somebody from Philadelphia here. You like this weather? All right. Well, we're doing a sound check for the press so they can get all of their equipment adjusted. And I'm just here to welcome you. I'm LaRon. The Miracles have a star here. The Supremes. Even the Osmonds have a star here. I know they're not from Motown. But it's a great corner, great location for us to be able to honor Boyz II Men. And our chamber staffer, who's our vice president of media relations and coordinates, this is Anna Martinez. She's running around, but she selects the different locations and tries to always select a location that'll be meaningful. So we're going to have a lot of fun today, and I know you can all cheer loud. You're part of the program. So if you hear, I hear one person who's good. Let's hear the rest of you. All right. So if you hear something you like, let's hear it. And with that, I think everyone has their equipment adjusted. We're just waiting for a couple of our participants to arrive, and we'll be back in another 5 or 10 minutes with the program. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, girl, I thought I got the side of his pants. Oh, I got a picture of Sean. Shut up. They're going to
look at me. Ceremony of 2012. Presented. That deserves some applause, absolutely. Today's ceremony is presented by the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce and the Hollywood Historic Trust. We are delighted today to honor one of the music world's most beloved R&B music groups as they are honored with a 2,456 star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Today, Hollywood honors Nathan Morris, Wanya Morris, and Sean Stockman, Boyz II Men. And we welcome them to the Walk of Fame. Let me tell you a little bit about our honorees. Boyz II Men redefined R&B and revolutionized the genre. Celebrating their 20th anniversary this past year, I think that deserves some applause, doesn't it? Their 20th anniversary. The band has penned and performed some of the most celebrated songs and timeless classics of the past two decades. The group's four Grammy Awards are just the tip of the iceberg. Throughout their 20-year career, Boyz II Men has also won a whopping 9 American Music Awards, 9 Soul Train Awards, and 3 Billboard Awards.
I'm gonna try to get a picture of me.
The group is the best-selling R&B group of all time. And get this, with an astounding 60 million albums sold. And the reason for that is abundantly clear. For the past two decades, Boyz II Men has given fans a catalog of iconic hits that just keep coming. Boyz II Men's most recent albums have earned them major critical acclaim. Their Decca label debut, Motown, A Journey Through Hitsville, USA. All right, some of you have that album. Let's hear it. Motown, A Journey Through Hitsville, USA, was released in 2007 and earned them 2 Grammy nominations. This collection of Detroit soul classics took the music scene by storm.
God, I gotta tape it.
Motown rose to number 27 on the Billboard Top 200 and to number 6 on the Trade's R&B Albums chart. The album also sparked the release of Boyz II Men's first full-length live concert DVD. Now, they followed up the success of Motown with another hit album, Love, released in 2009. And Boyz II Men marked the 20th anniversary of their group by releasing a landmark album, fittingly titled 20. Now, the multiple award-winning album contains this group's first original material in nearly a decade, as well as a dozen remastered classic career-defining hits. 20's first single, More Than You'll Ever Know, I know you like that one, More Than You'll Ever Know, cracked into the top 15 on Urban Adult Contemporary charts and is still climbing. Among Boyz II Men's biggest hits are, and if you hear one you like, let's hear it, End of the Road.
Yes!
I'll Make Love to You.
Yes!
One Sweet Day.
Yes!
And Motown Philly.
Yes!
And they go on and on. Boyz II Men has won fans the world over with their soulful multi-octave sound and incredible vocals. Given the monumental success of their albums and the timeless quality of their vocals, it's easy to see why Boyz II Men remains the most popular R&B group of all time. The group has its own charity called Boyz II Men House, which lends support to individuals and organizations which focus on improving quality of life and helping to unlock human potential. Boyz II Men has made R&B accessible to the masses and helped the genre come into its own. Fans throughout the world continue to flock to see them perform at sold-out shows. What a great way to start the new year with Boyz II Men receiving the very first star of 2012 on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. And so, please help me bring Nate, Wanya, and Sean to the stage.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning.
All right. Now, you don't get to speak yet. You have to just smile and wave. So let me also introduce a couple of other people we have with us. Mike McCary. Now, Our first speakers today, their names are synonymous with success. In fact, an amazing catalog of hit records made them the most successful production duo in contemporary music history. Their statistics are mind-boggling. Millions of sales on over 100 albums have exceeded gold and multi-platinum status, and they have a star on the Walk of Fame. Please welcome Famers Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis.
Yes. Well, it's a beautiful occasion today. Beautiful, beautiful sunshine, and I can't think of a better way to get up in the morning and others with this star on the Walk of Fame. I just want to talk about real quick how we met. Was we were fans of the group. They already had some hit records. They didn't really need us to make hit records, but for some reason, they came up to Cold, Minnesota in February, right around the All-Star game, I think. And they played us their album, and we basically told them, well, you know, all we really need to do is go to the store and buy the album because there's really nothing we can do. And they said, no, there's a song. We still need one song. And when we listened to the album, the one thing that we thought Boyz II Men did better than any other group, besides, you know, obviously sing better than any other group, was they begged better than any other group. And so we thought was a great begging song, and we thought kind of along that lines, and we came up with a song called On Bended Knee.
Wow. Yeah.
Now, the song didn't sound very much like the way they made it sound. Matter of fact, they have like a black male cassette of me trying to sing the vocal on it. But it did turn out to be a number one hit, and I just want to thank these gentlemen for their persistence in getting us involved and kind of our arms and saying, Jimmy and Terry, we need you to be a part of what it is we do. You know, the 20 years is crazy to be together that long. I will say, though, me and my partner are celebrating 40 this year, but you know, but we're a little older, you see, so that's how that works.
We started when we were one.
Yeah, when we were one, that's right. But anyway, I just want to say that these guys mean the world to us. The fact that they're here, and really history is here today, too, because, listen, there were four people in the group, and Mike McCary being here as part of the group today.
Yay!
Let's give it up for that. And it talks about the togetherness, the class, the brotherhood that these gentlemen continue to exude, and the class. In an industry where sometimes class doesn't really happen, these guys have made it. You know, they continue to show us and make us proud. And it's interesting that the biggest pop group in history happens to be an R&B group, which is very near and dear to our hearts. So how about that? So that's all. I'll turn it over to my partner, Terry Lewis.
And after that, Jimmy Jam, I can only say ditto. But I will say that it's great to be here today for some guys that represent the love of music, the passion of art. These guys are not just R&B. These guys are music. These guys love music and they're passionate about it. They can sing anything under the sun. And they're students and they're loving and they're caring. And it's great to see them all together.
Yep.
And that's big. So I'm giving it up now. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let me introduce the chairman of the board of the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, Marty Shelton. Wave. Back there. And we also want to acknowledge singer Michael Bivins, who's with us.
Go ahead, Michael.
Our next speaker, in a relatively short time, has reached icon status as a poignant tunesmith, prolific hitmaker producer, superstar recording artist, and revolutionary label owner. He is a statistical juggernaut who keeps adding milestone after milestone to a legacy that seems to have no threshold or peak in sight. Please welcome Kenny Babyface Edmonds.
Thank you. I'm very honored to be here with all of you guys today. To be here for Boyz II Men. I can only think of the first time that I met them, which was in Philadelphia. And I flew up there, me and L.A. Reid and Daryl Simmons, and we were going to work on this little song that we were going to do on a soundtrack called Boomerang. And it was just a little song, and little did we know that this song called End of the Road wasn't only the beginning. And amazing things happened. I remember they walked in the studio and they were like kind of scared. And I don't know why, because I was kind of scared of them. Because, you know, I had already heard them sing and I knew that they were just going to kill it. And we did that song in like 2 hours.
No problem.
It was 2 hours. And then they went back on tour, and then they were, and it was like when we finished it, we didn't know really what we had. We just thought we had a good song. And I think when it hit number one, you guys were still out on the road. Y'all didn't even know they heard the song went number one. Good. I said, what? And it was a beginning of a beautiful relationship with the guys, because we ended up doing more work together. And I think one of the best things that I got out of hanging out with Boyz II Men, I got my own nickname. And my nickname is, they look at everything backwards, and so my name is Isefi Bap. Thank you. And I can call them Nim Ut Yab. From this moment on, they will be known as Nim Ut Yab. Yes. That's a good R&B group name. I like that. I like it. But on the serious side, I'm very, very proud. And this is long overdue. They needed this star. It was something. They've been stars to all of us for a very long time. So give it up to Boyz II Men. Yeah, good job.
The Hollywood Chamber of Commerce administers the Walk of Fame on behalf of the City of Los Angeles. All right, we have a special request for Michael to come up and say a few words.
Mike Bivins.
And while he's coming up, let me continue to say that the City of LA has a beautiful resolution. Now, they've only got one here, but I'm assured they're going to prepare some additional ones, so you each have
we'll share
one.
It.
So if you want to hold that, gentlemen, photos to the press. And then we'll hear from Michael. So why don't you pose there with the Rezo and then Michael.
Swing around there.
Okay, which way? Right here or in front? Okay, in front.
One, two. Check, one, two.
And now Michael Bivins.
Yay, Mike.
Yes. I would just like to say that nobody really knows the journey, where this all really started, what the vision was, what the plan was, and the things we had against us. I mean, first of all, you know, they were four kids from Philly that went to the School of Performing Arts, and they had a dream to be in the music business, but they were being taught how to sing correctly. And we kind of brought to the table what they were already doing, being professional, having professional voices. And if you notice, when Boyz II Men got introduced to the music business, they were already in the game as if they'd been in the game for 4 or 5 years. And there's a gentleman that's resting in peace, Mr. Gerald Busby, who was the president of Motown Records. When I told him about these guys, I asked him to go visit them, and he sat in a hotel room and they sang a cappella to him. And right then and there was the birth of Biv Entertainment, which was the first production company they were signed to. And not only did he give me an opportunity as an executive, but he also gave them a dream. And I just want to say, Gerald, if you're looking down at us, man, we just want you to know we love you. You put a lot of hard work into this. You employed a lot of people. There's a lot of executives behind us who were put on by Gerald. I see Mr. Clarence Avant back there. And we just want you to know this day will not go without you being noticed, man. And you mean so much to us as a father, a friend, and a godfather. And it's really not my moment. If y'all know me, I could talk all day. So I'm definitely going to get off this microphone. But I will say to see Sean's mom and Nate's mom, I just remember eating turkey sandwiches in Nate's room. And we was trying to figure out what we were going to do. We were all so young, and we had it on a paper plate and some paper cups. And from Philadelphia to Hollywood Boulevard, Mama, we did it. And I'm proud of her.
Thank you, Michael. The longtime honorary mayor of Hollywood, Johnny Grant, presided over the Walk of Fame for nearly 30 years. He passed away 4 years ago this week. We miss Johnny greatly, but in his memory, we always declare this day special. And so in the memory of Johnny Grant, I hereby declare this Boyz II Men Day in Hollywood.
God is good.
Yes, he is, all the time.
I promised I wasn't going to get all emotional.
You always
go for
cry.
It.
Come on, give me a tip.
Good to see Mike, as he still teases. This is a great day. I have so many.
It's all right. It's okay.
I will be 40. I have so many things to say, but I'll keep it quick as possible because I know the rest of the guys have to talk too. I'd first like to again thank God and acknowledge God and the Lord Savior Jesus Christ for just allowing us to be at least intuitive enough to stay together when things, you know, kind of fell apart in a lot of places, and we didn't have a lot of answers, had more questions than answers as far as where we would go in life, let alone this music industry. We managed to have the wisdom and understanding to know that we're better off together than we are apart. And it's paid off. And this is probably one of the proudest moments of my life. I'd like to also acknowledge my mother, Nathan's mother, my wife, Sharonda, my son, Ty, who is here, all of my good friends and family who have come to share this occasion. I mean, the beautiful thing about this is that some of these people I haven't seen in about 10, 15 years, and it's even deeper than the star itself. It brought true love and true friendship back together. And this is a great, great, great moment. And I would like to also send a spiritual shout out to Mr. Khalil Roundtree, who was our first road manager and somewhat of a father figure to us. And I know he's looking down, smiling, with his big chains on and his big cigar. And this is just I can't explain how happy I am. This is one of the happiest days of my life. And I thank all of our fans who we affectionately call them soldiers. We thank you so much for being here, and for those of you who are there in spirit and everything. We thank you so very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Wow. I concur with Sean. God is definitely good. He blessed us with the understanding that we needed to bless the world with the gift that he gave us, and that's the gift of music, the gift of song. A lot of people don't know what goes into recording a Boyz II Men song, but if you're looking at us right now and you can see straight through us, you could see that our hearts bleed music. We do this for one reason and one reason only, and that's because we love it.
and we love to be recognized for the music that we give. I mean, it's the best feeling in the world to even be able to, 20 years later, be standing here in front of everybody and being appreciated, which means that we did our jobs, and the job that we did is memorable. I want to thank everybody that's been a part of our lives for 20 years, those who are distant and rooting for us, those who are here and fighting for us, everyone who came out to bless us with their presence. This is an incredible situation, and you know, we're going to take it just like we take everything else, and that's like a blessing. Khalil Roundtree, he was not just like a father. Sure. My dad, he sent me on a roll when I was 15 years old, and the only way that he felt comfortable was because Khalil was with us, and he is not ever, it's not a day that goes by that we don't think about him. Mr. Michael Bivins, I was a dude from the projects. You know, I was eating $1.25 sandwiches and quarter juices, you know what I'm saying? And the opportunity, the friendship, the brother, the prowess, the vision, all of those things are just looked at and I admire it, and I look to in the future be able to hopefully do the same thing for other artists. My brothers, man. Nate, Sean, and Mike, we've been through a lot, man, and the ups and downs are crazy, you know, but the beautiful thing about being here right now, is that I know that these guys feel the same way that I do about music, about love, and about God, and that right there is what binds us. That's the tie that binds us, and as long as, I say this all the time, as long as there's good music in the world, Boyz II Men will do our best to reach deep down in our souls and give that to you to the best of our abilities. If we mess up every now and then, please forgive us. Everybody does. But if we're successful and continue to be successful, we ask that you root for us, because we are trying and definitely pushing forward to be the ambassadors of real music, real love songs, and just artists all around the world who want to express themselves with an artistic value. I want to thank our families, our kids, our friends, and everybody that's here. We really appreciate you. Thank you.
Hey, how's it going, everybody?
What's up?
First and foremost, I would like to thank our Lord and Christ, Savior, Jesus Christ, man, because without him, I promise you, none of this would be possible. And if you don't know him, please get to know him. Accept him into your hearts today, please. Because trust me, there is a God. Seeing the four of us on stage today after 20 years, you guys so much, man. I haven't seen Mama Gail in so long, man. I have not seen Miss Stockman, Mama Stockman, nobody in so long, man, but I do love you guys, man. Don't ever get that confused. I love you so much. You know that. To see Biv, man, Quadri, E. Safi, Bab, Jimmy and Jim, man, Terry Lewis, man, oh my God. And all of our friends today, man. Wow. Trust me, I'm going to smile for the rest of the year. I'm going to smile. I'm just going to wake up every day like this. I promise you, you think I'm joking. I send you a picture every day on the email, I promise. I mean, really, man, this is a true blessing, man. To be up here with my three brothers back here, man, I love you guys, man. I love you guys, man. Don't ever get it twisted. I love you guys. So y'all know it, man. I'm a 40-year-old dude telling three other dudes I love y'all. So that's love. So God bless y'all, man. I'm gonna pass the mic over to Mr. Nathan Morris.
I had a bunch of people ask me how you're supposed to feel today. Are you excited? And
I didn't really know what to feel because this has never really happened for me or for my guys before. I'm one that's used to situations. I like to know what I'm getting into before I get into it, and this is undiscovered territory for me. I don't really know what to say. I just know that 20 years ago, there were people in my life that decided to make choices. And this is when I was young and didn't really know the choices to make myself. And my mom thought it was important for me to do music. And I was young, didn't know any better. Eventually, I wanted to play football, do something else. But my mom and I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's all right.
For real. God bless you, Nate. It's
okay. Don't take too long. I want to acknowledge two people that are very important to my life and my group, because if they didn't walk me down the right path, none of us would be here today. I brought my my grade school music teacher and my middle school music teacher to stand up. And if it wasn't for them, none of us would even be out here today. They passed us on to high school, to Mike Bivins, all the Motown people that are here today, everybody that's just been there for us. And as you get older, you realize life is about choices. And you guys made a choice to come out here today and be a part of this. Everybody out here has made a choice, some kind of way, to be a part of Boyz II Men. And we appreciate it from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you know our management, Joe Moverhill and Whitney Fatone, for being there and kind of helping us get back on track when we thought we lost it all. And again, so many people here from the beginning that have done so much for us that we never get a chance to say thank you for. We never get a chance to appreciate. And we have something special at Motown because it seems like today a lot of those executives are really big people in the music industry today. And that's because we had a special nucleus over there that helped us get to where we are. And always understand, Boyz II Men is not about four guys. Boyz II Men is about everyone who supports Boyz II Men. There's no way we could ever be what we are and who we are without everybody else being who they are and supporting Boyz II Men. So for everything that we've done, this is much as an honor to you guys as it is for us. This star belongs to each and every one of you as well. Thank you for everything you've done for us, and we love you very much.
What a way to begin the year. Let's unveil the star.
Take it. I'm afraid. I'm afraid.
Teena Marie.
Thank you. Man, beautiful loss, man. Beautiful loss. One of the voice, incredible voices ever.
What's your favorite Teena Marie song?
I lied to my job while you ain't smile. Got me?
Shout out for
Arnold. Thank you. All right.
What's your favorite Teena Marie song?
Portuguese Say Love.
Why?
Just love it. It's a beautiful record.
Thank you.
You listen to that song, Bend the Knee? Bend the Knee? I love that song.
Oh, I gotta go. Sorry,
she had the cheap seats in the back.
Oh Okay,
I got it.
Let the lady go first. I'll take it inside.
Okay.
No.
Yeah. If I can.
You can do it, man. How you feel?
I don't want to do that.
Come on, you got to.
Take care now.
Go.
Hey, happy New Year.
Thank you, sir. Call his name.
Taking a picture. I'm on my way out.
Come on, Teena, man.
You
I'm on my
way out. Thank you very much. Oh, Teena,
yeah. Everybody already knows that.
Your favorite song?
I've got to talk about
your favorite Teena song?
Need Your Lover.
Thank you, man.
Good. Good to see you. Get my
camera.
How?
Hell yeah.
Well, I thought that went on the
man. No, I just
thought it was a while ago.
Let's see your star.
Let's see your star.
Yes.
How are you?
What's your thoughts on Teena Marie?
One more time.
What's your thoughts on Teena Marie?
Come on, man. You know I love Teena Marie.
What's your favorite Teena Marie song?
Good.
All of them, my God. I mean, you can't. They all. First of all, every song is alike. Okay. Same melody, same structure. So you, if you like one, you love them all. Honestly. You know what I'm saying? So I love them all. I just love Teena.
This is going to Teena Marie's band site.
Is it really going
there? Yes, it is.
Man, much love. Respect to everyone out there, man. God bless you guys.
Thank you, man.